Welcome to the 2017 University of Detroit Jesuit High School Student Senate Debates, brought to you by the Cub Broadcast.
My name is Neil Jen, and I am joined today by Grayson Huldin. We will serve as your... If we could settle down, we will serve as your moderators for this event. Before we... Okay. Decorum. Settle down. Before we begin, we want to go over the format for the debate. Stop. Our first candidates to step up to the podium will be those running for the office of Sergeant at Arms, followed by the candidates for Treasurer, Secretary, Vice President, and finally, President. Before taking questions, a candidate will have 1 minute to introduce himself. The candidate who received the most votes in the primaries will speak first. After introductions, questions will be posed to the candidates. The candidate who received the most votes in the primaries will determine if he would like to answer the initial question first, or if he would like to defer to his opponent. Candidates will alter who responds first, following the initial question. Each candidate will have 1 minute, 30 seconds to respond to a given question. If a candidate would like to follow up on his opponent's remarks, he must signal the moderators. We will yield a candidate an opportunity for follow-up only if there is sufficient time on the clock and we feel further elaboration would be helpful. As moderators, we also reserve the right to interject as we see fit or to request a candidate to clarify his response.
In order to have a fair, respectful debate, we are asking that the members of the audience conduct themselves appropriately. Cheering and applause is appropriate after a candidate's remark, but students should be quiet while a candidate is speaking. It takes a great deal of courage to put yourself out there in front of the entire student body. Please be respectful of our candidates by listening attentively and cheering appropriately. Teachers, your help is requested in encouraging proper decorum. We are now ready to begin today's debate. We will start with the candidates for Sergeant at Arms. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Mr. Daniel Barber and Sean Rossler. Mr. Rossler, you won the primary, so you may speak first. You have 1 minute.
What up, Cubs? I'm Sean Rossler, and I'm running to be your next Sergeant at Arms. I've loved my time at U of D, and I want to establish the same sense of Cub pride in each of you. I'm qualified for Sarge because of my ability to succeed in the face of adversity and my leadership experience, which include being the student section co-chair, a homeroom representative, as well as having leadership roles on the football and lacrosse teams. I have been on the honor roll every semester. I have also been a part of clubs such as BASE, Pro-Life, and Labre Ministry. I am running because I believe that together we can make the Jez even better. My campaign ideas include updating the school cell phone policy, allowing every homeroom into the intramural playoffs, and instituting Cub Pride Awards for both grades and individual students, as well as many more policy improvements. Not only am I immensely involved in the Cub community, I truly believe in the brotherhood here at U of D. So on May 12th, remember who takes charge. Vote Rossler for Sarge.
Thank you, Mr. Rossler. Mr. Barber, you may now go. You will have 1 minute.
Thank you, Cubs. My name is Dan Barber. I'm running for Sergeant at Arms. What is a Sergeant at Arms? Pretty much a strong leader who looks awesome banging a gavel. I remember being here last year and the year before that, and the year before that, sitting right next to all of you guys. You guys are the number one reason that I'm up here today. We all know that there's some things that need to change here at U of D next year. The cell phone policy, the student sections, the dress code, the emotionally crippling amount of homework. Well, I'll see what I can do about the first three. I've said it before, but I'll say it again, because there's nothing more important that I can say. The Senate belongs to the students. This is for you guys. God bless. Go Cubs. Vote for Sergeant Dan.
Thank you, Mr. Barber. Mr. Osler, you won the primary, so therefore, you will be able to decide if you would like to answer first or defer the following question to Mr. Barber. Part of the job of the Sergeant-at-Arms is to keep order and hold Senate members accountable. How would you handle a situation in which a homeroom senator was routinely absent from Senate and committee members? What would you like to do, sir?
I'll answer.
All right, you will have 1 minute 30, and you may now begin.
If a homeroom senator were to routinely be absent, you would have to clearly establish that he has to be more available, and you would have to maybe even kick him off. Like, you would have to have a discussion with him first, and then you would also have to have a group meeting with the other senator, with my fellow candidates, discussing whether or not he should be kicked off the Senate. Now, attendance is very important at every meeting, and if you don't come to the Senate meetings, it shows a lack of respect for the Senate, and you can't have that. Leadership is very important in any single stance. To quote John Quincy Adams, if your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, you are a leader. You aren't a leader if you're absent.
Thank you, Mr. Osler. Mr. Barber, same question to you, sir.
Well, as a homeroom representative for 3C, this is my third term right now, I take this commitment seriously. I think a homeroom rep is the primary basis between connecting the Senate to the students. They work really closely with all the students and pretty much make it all happen. I think that's really important to do. So if a senator is consistently absent, that means they're not taking that seriously. I think that's a problem. The first thing that I would do as a sergeant at arms is speak to that student directly. I don't think you have to go straight to the top. I think I could handle that with them. If the situation didn't fix itself after I worked them, I think you would have to approach the Senate. The Constitution outlines that it's the Judiciary Committee's responsibility to handle chronic absences or possible impeachments. And I don't want to go there if I don't have to. But again, if it's necessary, I trust the system, and I'll follow that.
Thank you, Mr. Barber.
What does that repeat?
Thank you, Mr. Barber. Moving on to question number two. Mr. Barber, students often complain about the number of jugs issued to students, and yet, most would agree that rules are essential for any community. Could you please address an infraction that you think is not a fair rule that would warrant a jug? What steps can be taken to improve this? You have a minute, 30 seconds.
Thank you, Neil. I think that some infractions are obviously more serious than others. And I don't think it's fair that just one jug policy should cover all of these. For example, a story that I've heard is an untied shoelace that resulted in a jug. And I don't think that's fair. It's not something that the student would have done on purpose or maybe even noticed. I don't think that should be up there with breaking the traffic pattern voluntarily or going against school policy or anything like that that they would choose to do. So my proposal is that we have different levels of jug. I don't think 45 minutes is fair for something small like that. I think there should be other assignments, possibly different types of punishment for something that's not as serious as a bigger infraction.
Thank you, Mr. Barber. Mr. Rossler, same question. You have a minute and 30 seconds.
Thank you. I agree with Dan in that some infractions are much more important than others. For example, things like no belt, no ID, they're not that big of a deal, and they should even be given, they should be given warnings. Like boots not being tied, that should not be a jug. Now, these infractions should not be served for the full 30 minutes as like something as severe as disrespecting a teacher in class. And as your sergeant at arms, I would like to establish having even ideas such as making sure that even working or writing a paper to help instead of going to jug, you could just write a paper or even work out with the school.
Thank you, Mr. Rossler. Mr. Barber, I'd like to elaborate quickly on your point regarding different punishments. You have 30 seconds to elaborate further on this idea.
Thank you, Neil. I agree with Sean's idea. I am absolutely in favor of searching for other solutions instead of a full jug for those minor infractions. However, I don't think a paper is the best way to do it. I don't think writing a paper will teach you anything about how to button your pants or whatever. I propose a service project. I want to do something that actually makes a difference in the school and corrects the error.
Thank you, Mr. Barber. Mr. Rossler, 30-second response.
I appreciate that advice, and clearly everything we can do can be worked out. It's a good point that a paper may not serve as the best means for punishment, but it will also establish an idea of having the student realize that he has made a mistake.
Thank you, Mr. Rossler. Mr. Rossler, the third question is first directed at you. What are two concrete things, please be specific, that you can do to lower the number of students who are 245 men?
Thank you for that question. Being a 245 guy is not something that I want U of D people to be. Personally, I'm at school every day from 9 to 14 hours a day, and every student should be experiencing that as well. To not be a 245 guy, we can have club meetings where it just displays every single club at U of D, because I feel like that the only time we really see the clubs is during the convention, like the Cub convention when we're all in here. And then I also would like to have announcements of club meetings during homeroom too, to help establish when homerooms can be, so we can realize, so kids can really get into other things.
Quick question there, Mr. Osler. Aren't homeroom announcements already filled with clubs? Like, with for example, clubs put in a club in the announcements. How can we get those announcements better?
The Cub broadcast.
Exactly.
You can't really hear it, like, on the announcements. I'm saying you put it on the Cub broadcast. You can't really hear on the Cub broadcast. It's not really.
Okay. So you're saying we can just work to make the announcements more hearable then?
Establish them in the Cub broadcast.
Okay. And then you can continue still. Mr. Barber, the question is to you.
Thank you, Grayson. I have never been a 245 man from 7th grade till today. There are just so many clubs, so many co-curriculars, so many things to do. There's really something for everybody. And I think that every student needs to be a part of something more than just sitting in the classroom and being assigned work to do. One great way to get involved after 245 is through student sections. We have many sports and many home games, and it's great to get out there and get rowdy with the boys in the section. However, this year I was sort of disappointed. We had some great moments in the student section for sure, filled the bowl, but it's really been lacking. And I think raising awareness about this, getting those announcements out there more than a day or two before the game so students can plan ahead and get out there and have a great time is a perfect way to fix that issue. In addition to this, I think my second step would be making the availability out there for more students to propose new clubs. All you guys have so many diverse interests, and I think you guys need to be able to share those with the school. So I think if it's easier for you guys to propose a new club or a new group or a new idea, you guys can get together and share that with everybody.
30 seconds for you, Mr. Barber. Actually, probably just 15. You said you want to get more students in the student section. What's a concrete thing, how you could do that? You weren't very specific there, so if you could specify how you'd get more students in the student section.
Yeah, I think it's all about awareness. You can't show up to a game if you don't know that it exists. And putting that out through as many means possible, Twitter, Cub broadcast, homeroom announcements, is the way to solve that issue.
Thank you, Mr. Barber. Please join me in thanking and congratulating the candidates for the office of Sergeant at Arms.
Moving on to the office of Treasurer, please welcome to the stand Mr. Benjamin Godfrey and Mr. Brendan Neary. Thank you, gentlemen. As a reminder, you will each have 1 minute to briefly introduce yourself to the audience. Mr. Godfrey, you have 1 minute.
Hey Cubs, my name is Ben Godfrey, and I'm running for officer because I have questions. We all know the Pledge Detroit fundraiser does a lot of good for the school, but we, the students, only know the location of about 15% of those funds, and that goes to our clubs. Wouldn't it be nice to know where the other 85% of that money's going? If we raise the money, we have a right to know where it's going. Also, if the bell starts class, how come it doesn't always dismiss it?
Settle down, settle down.
What's the purpose of trash cans in the bathrooms if there's no paper towel to be put in them? If elected, I plan on creating answers to some of these problems and many more. Remember, vote Ben for Trez.
Thank you, Mr. Godfrey. Mr. Neary, 1 minute.
What up, Cubs? My name is Brendan Neary, and I'm running to be your student senate treasurer for next school year. I'm running for office because I want to make next year the best year possible, and I think I can make that happen for everyone. I'm very qualified for the position, having been in the Senate as both a homeroom rep and a co-chair on the Judiciary Committee. In addition to that, I'm also involved in National Honor Society, Inscape, and varsity hockey and lacrosse, all while keeping a 4.07 cumulative GPA. I will work tirelessly to make next year enjoyable for everyone in all aspects at the high, and I understand what is required for this position, and I'm ready to be your next Student Senate Treasurer. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Neary. With that out of the way, let's begin the debate. Our first question today, what are your thoughts on how money is distributed to clubs, athletic programs, and other departments within the school? Is there anything you would like to see changed in this regard? Mr. Godfrey, as the winner of the primary, you can choose to respond first or defer this question to Mr. Neary.
I'll respond first.
You have 1 minute, 30 seconds.
I believe that the way we distribute money is a flawed system, a system that can't be fixed. The money is based into planks, and it turns into a popularity contest between the members and the Senate into what plank wins. All clubs deserve to have the right amount of money designated. However, we do have a strict budget, and I promise that if elected, I'm going to create a fair budget so all clubs get at all the money they attempt to deserve. However, there are going to be some shortcomings because of that budget, and I plan on creating a system where individual clubs can have fundraisers to get the money if they still need it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Godfrey. Mr. Neary, same question, 1 minute, 30 seconds.
I get where Ben's coming from, but I think it's important to understand that as a treasurer, it's our duty simply to understand all the clubs and where they're coming from and simply make the budgets that the Senate votes on. So the treasurer does not make the budget for each individual club. They simply set the planks for the whole Senate to vote on. So it's not one person's responsibility to create all the budgets for one club. And I do my best to create a fair budget that the Senate can vote on, where each club can get the maximum amount of money for the fundraiser, for activities and trips that they want to do.
Thank you, Mr. Neary. Mr. Godfrey, would you be able to further elaborate on the implementation of fairness for each club appropriation? You have 30 seconds.
Yeah, so fairness is a big issue. A lot of times the competitive clubs get a lot of money, but we need to set aside money for the smaller clubs to grow and continue to support U of D in their mission and its mission. A big issue is the fact of the popularity that Brendan didn't mention. Is if you have a part of a club and you don't have any members in Senate, you're probably not going to get the money you deserve. That needs to be fixed by allowing individual fundraisers, so people can fight for their own money if they don't have the popularity in the Senate.
Thank you, Mr. Godfrey. Mr. Neary, 30 seconds.
Despite what Ben says, I don't think the Senate falls for popularity competitions and that the Senate is unbiased in their choices. But in addition to that, it's important to know that each club gets to choose a representative to go in front of all of the officers and request a certain amount of money. So the amount of money they get comes more from their meeting with the officers and how they present their club and the activities that they want to do rather than just appealing to the Senate.
Thank you, Mr. Neary.
Mr. Neary, this question goes first to you. Pledge of Detroit brings in a substantial amount of money for student activities. Should there be repercussions for a student who does not bring in the required funds? What do you think is an appropriate consequence for not bringing in Pledge Detroit money?
Well, currently there already is a repercussion. When you don't bring in the money, you have to come in on the days we get off and go for a work day. And I think that's a fair punishment. If you don't get the pledges and bring the money that is required, then you have to come in on the day off that you would earn if you had paid the money.
Mr. Godfrey, same question to you.
First of all, I'm going to say that through my experience in Pledge Detroit, I've always raised more money than the required amount for the second semester dress down day. I believe that people do not bring in money for the Pledge Detroit, you're hurting your fellow brothers. By you not bringing in your $140 this year, you're not helping clubs and get the money they desperately deserve. Because of that, I feel like the repercussions in system now are good, but also a requirement of additional fundraising to make sure that more money is brought in. So if you don't bring in your money, there's be another work day, in addition to the normal work day, another fundraising opportunity to help bring in more money to make up for the delay that you didn't bring in your funds.
So let me get what you're saying correctly. You're saying that as punishment, it should be the work day, but you still have to bring in the money then?
I believe it should. Of course, there are economic issues, and that can be discussed in private. But it is critical that everybody contributes to the fund.
Okay.
We are a brotherhood. We go down as a brotherhood, but we need to succeed as one.
Okay. Mr. Neary, do you have a response?
I'd like to say that if someone doesn't bring in the money in the first place, that's for a reason. No one's just forgetting to do this. It's well advertised. If they're not bringing in their money, they're not going to be able to bring it in the second time for the same exact reason they didn't the first time.
Mr. Godfrey, this question will go to you. What is your biggest goal for the next year? And what concrete, specific steps do you plan to take to achieve this goal?
My biggest goal is introducing transparency to the Student Senate. I want to keep you guys updated on what's going on. One of the biggest problems is in the school's involvement. And because of that, I want to create a website that tracks, keeps track of athletic schedules, club news, and other, like a ride-sharing system. If you can't get to an event, I want you to find a ride to be able to get to that. But going back to the transparency, I want to have weekly videos of all five of us elected, keeping tabs on what we're doing for you guys to make the school a better place. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Godfrey. Mr. Neary, same question. 1 minute, 30 seconds.
My biggest goal next year is for the Senate to have enough money and to distribute to clubs so they can have the activities and trips that they want to do. My plan for doing that is by having activities like dances and the U of D Mercy Dodgeball Tournament that generates money for the Senate that can then be distributed to the clubs so they can do what they want to do with their members and for trips and stuff like that.
Thank you, Mr. Neary. Mr. Godfrey, I'd like to cover more of this website. Do you have any specific time frame for, if you are elected, when this could be implemented?
As soon as I'm elected, I want to get started working on it as soon as possible. Even though we're elected for next year, we can still start at the end of this year to create the website and to get everybody in charge. We can run it through a beta test system. And another thing is with the website, some events we can do, like the dodgeball, raise money for funds. And that would get more participation because of the website and not the announcements. The announcements are a dead system. Nobody in home, a good majority of people in homeroom do not listen to those announcements, which is why we need the website.
Thank you, Mr. Godfrey. Mr. Neary, you have 30 seconds.
To say that the announcement system is a dead system, I think is unfair because there's many people, including the Cub broadcast team, that goes in every day and puts in hard work for to get announcements to the school. And to say that it's a dead system is just disrespectful to that club and hard work that people put in.
Thank you, Mr. Neary. Mr. Godfrey, this is your last response.
But even, I acknowledge that they're doing hard work, and I appreciate it. But the problem is, I know a lot of homerooms that don't watch the announcements.
Thank you, Mr. Godfrey. Thank you, gentlemen. Please join me in giving another round of applause to our candidates for the office of Sergeant at Arms. A debate requires two people. Since one of the candidates for secretary is not present, we will be temporarily omitting that portion of the debate and proceeding to the vice presidential debate. Please welcome to the stand the candidates for vice president, Mr. Sean Butler and Mr. Noah Zielinski. Thank you, gentlemen. As a reminder, you will each have 1 minute to briefly introduce yourself to the audience. Mr. Butler, you're up first.
Good morning. I'm Sean Butler, and I'm running to be your next Student Senate Vice President. During my 3 years at U of D Jesuit, I organized a successful Pledge Detroit fundraiser as a Senate co-chair. I've represented my homeroom at Senate meetings. I've run varsity track and cross country, served others through the pastoral core team, labor ministry, and ISC, participated in other co-curricular activities such as Quiz Bowl and Inscape, and maintained a 4.1 GPA. Through these activities, I have learned that I must work my hardest to achieve my goals. I will bring that same work ethic to the Senate next year if I'm elected as VP. It will not just be about working hard. I have ideas to create positive change that I look forward to discussing with you today. I want a Senate that is more organized and representative for every student. Better student sections, better dances, better activities, better policies, and a better school year for all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Butler. Mr. Zielinski, you have 1 minute.
Good morning, Cubs. I'm Noah Zielinski, and I'm running to be your next Student Senate Vice President. Here's a little bit about me. I have two brothers in the academy, I'm a two-time swim captain, and I have dyslexia. Imagine this. Imagine going to an academically challenging school and not being able to read half the stuff that is given to you. That is me every day. I'm telling you that I have dyslexia because I have creative ways of learning a different way. I have to be creative with challenges I face. I will use these skills to find different solutions to old problems. I learn differently, therefore I will have different solutions to problems. Now my goals. The two major goals I want to focus on are to better promote all activities around the school and to change the late policy. I know the second goal is a long shot, but I will work to open up the conversation with the administration to change the policy. I want to make next year the best it can be.
Thank you, Mr. Zielinski. With that out of the way, let's begin the debate. Our first question today. In light of recent U.S. elections, the country seems to be divided on many levels, and some might say there's division at U of D Jesuit as well. What will you do as Vice President to unite the student body? Mr. Butler, as the winner of the primary, you can choose to respond first or defer this question to Mr. Zielinski.
I'll respond first.
You have 1 minute, 30 seconds.
All right. The U of D Jesuit community is obviously very diverse. Although we are diverse, we may also be divided. We have different viewpoints, different religions, different races, different activities, different passions. We all deserve to have the best experience we can at U of D. To unite the student body, we need school spirit. We must all be passionate about our school, no matter what activity you're in. Some people are passionate about some things, and some people are passionate about other things. My goal is to make people passionate about everything, and in turn, U of D Jesuit.
Thank you, Mr. Butler. Mr. Zielinski, same question, 1 minute, 30 seconds.
To me, it's hard to see the difference in the cultures around U of D. As Vice President next year, I will make sure that everyone feels welcome and feels that they belong to the school. If I see someone sitting by themselves, I'll go sit with them, I'll go start talking to them, and I'll make sure they feel like they're part of this community. To be able to open up this community is something that has been a challenge this whole time, because you have the different places, different clubs for different people, and that do not interest other people. And so I want to make it easier for everyone to feel welcome, to feel like they're watching this school. Another thing, U of D is very diverse, and that's what makes U of D U of D. We have different races, we have different cultures, we have people from all over Michigan. I feel like we should own up to this and actually accept it and use it to something to help us in the future, where as we will further on through the school and the years the school is around, U of D is something great, and being diverse is an opportunity, and we should take a hold of it and actually use it to our advantage to help us next year or help us throughout the years.
Thank you, Mr. Zielinski. I'd like to elaborate further on how the two of you would foster understanding between different backgrounds. Mr. Butler, 30 seconds.
I just want to stress that I don't believe that the U of D Jesuit community is very divided. Like, we've seen this through the different events that have happened throughout this year, such as the Sean English accident and different deaths in our community. We've all united through those activities, through those tragic events, and it's really shown how strong the Brotherhood is and how united we all are. We're not divided.
Thank you, Mr. Butler. Mr. Zielinski, you have 30 seconds.
I fully agree with Sean. Sean is very right when it comes to the point of how certain situations pull us together and it makes us a strong community. I want the same things that happened throughout this year to be going on through years in and years out. The same strength that we saw to support Sean, I want to have that exact same strength throughout all the U of D career.
Thank you, Mr. Zielinski.
Gentlemen, besides the new Science Center, the most major recent addition to the school was the construction of the auxiliary gym, athletic offices, and the weight room. And now, as reported in the last issue of the Cub News, perhaps next year, the school is hoping to purchase additional land that can be used for athletic practices and conditioning. Is the focus on athletics critical to the success of our school? Is the school placing too much emphasis on athletics at the expense of our fine arts, theater, and music programs? Mr. Zielinski, it's yours.
I believe that athletics play a big role in high school and a big role in the community. But I believe that that U of D is very different from other schools. We aren't like Brother Rice and just focus on sports at all. We focus on our academics, our other focus on everything else that's different around the school. And I feel like everyone is equal and they need extra help. One of my goals that I previously stated is to better promote everything. With every single co-curricular and every single club, we need to make sure that everyone feels like they want them to be here. They want them to enjoy their time here. Instead of people like just worrying about, oh, what sport's next or what game's next, let's focus more on, oh, when's the next art festival? When's the next time the Quiz Bowl's competing? When's the next time another important thing of the school is happening?
Thank you, Mr. Zielinski. Mr. Butler?
I just want to start out by saying that during my time at U of D, I've been a member of all three of those activities. I've been an athlete with track and cross country. I was in Les Mis my freshman year, and I'm in the band, both symphonic and marching. So I understand what it's like to have inadequate facilities and not enough funding or support for the activities that I'm in. That being said, I think purchasing the new land for the new athletics is a good decision, because at that site we can also promote the finer arts. There could be a facility for the band. There can be a facility for the play too. It's not just about athletics. We need to embrace our diverse culture here at U of D, every club, every activity.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Mr. Butler, this question will go to you. Student feedback on pep rallies has been mixed. What ideas do you have for improving our pep rallies here at U of D? You have a minute, 30 seconds.
So pep rallies, I know, they can be a little bit boring sometimes, but they can also be pretty fun. Some of the funner activities have been the student faculty game and the rock, paper, scissors, pie throwing contest. I think it'd be a good idea to bring back the most popular ideas and get student suggestions as well. It would be important to get the student senate or the student section committee involved in planning for the pep rallies. Committees need to play a big role in the planning of Senate events, especially pep rallies.
Thank you, Mr. Butler. I'd just like to remind the audience to please be quiet and pay attention to the answers of the candidates. Mr. Zielinski, same question, same amount of time.
Each pep rally, I've heard mixed reviews from different friends and different classmates and from all grades. I personally feel like we should change some of the events that go on and actually involve more people. Instead of just having one or two kids from each grade, involve the faculty in more. Involve the faculty in certain games and involve the faculty so you have that competition with your teachers and you can kind of compete against them. If you like them or if you don't, it's still going to be a fun experience. And I like to point on what Sean said and have each club be a member of kind of help planning. With each club, they all mean something and they all have a say in this in the school. So if they are able to help with something as the pep rally, which is a big thing, it's going to help benefit them and make them feel more like they're part of the U of D community and make them feel like they're welcome and they want to be in the school.
Thank you, Mr. Zielinski. I'd like to briefly return to a previous point made in this debate. So regarding the expansion of activities in pep rally to more popular ones, how would the Senate facilitate the process of gathering which clubs and which activities are more popular and would like to be presented in the pep rallies?
Well, I think that the best way to make pep rallies better is to have more enthusiasm from every student. We need students and Cubs who want to support their fellow peers, no matter what sport, whether that be football, soccer, hockey, basketball, lacrosse, whatever. It doesn't matter what activity, what club, what sport. You should be getting support from all your fellow Cubs.
Thank you, Mr. Butler. Mr. Zielinski, same question.
As Sean said, getting support from your fellow Cubs. I'm a swimmer and we barely get anyone out to our swim meets or barely get anyone supporting us. And I know that feeling from everyone who plays from playing track or running cross country or playing tennis. It's a struggle and we need the support and we need help. And that's one thing that I want to do next year and I want to change is to better involve everyone and better involve all the certain all the clubs together and make sure that we're all together as one.
Thank you, Mr. Zielinski.
Gentlemen, academic stress is a major concern among students who feel that they receive too much homework and oftentimes there are too many tests all on the same day. But this is a two-way street. Of course, and while the school can probably do a better job of easing some of this academic stress, students also have a large role to play. What do you think this role is? What is the responsibility of students in this regard? And what is the responsibility of the school? Mr. Zielinski, you have a minute, 30 seconds.
Thank you, Grayson. Going to the school, you kind of notice and kind of realize that the workload that you're going to get is going to be significant. And as a student with dyslexia, it's harder for me to balance 4 tests in one day and a couple quizzes. And I would like to talk to the administration and to make sure and to see if there's any way we can limit that down to a little bit. And I know it's part of the schedule and teachers have to get it done, but for the students that it's very stressful and it will cause them to just do things that they wouldn't normally do. I want to look out for the students. I want to make sure each student is represented equally and has a fair say in the Senate. So if you see me around the hall, you're more than welcome to come up and talk to me and tell me about your day and tell me about how many tests and quizzes you have and how stressed out you are. Because either talking to someone or trying to limit everything, it's the best way. And you don't want to become overly stressed because if you do, then it may not be in your favor.
Mr. Butler, you have your response time.
I know how difficult it is to balance the different activities here at U of D. Personally, I've struggled at times balancing academics, sports, clubs, and Senate activities, such as student sections. I've had many late nights doing my homework and staying up late just trying to finish my basic assignments for my basic classes. That being said, it's important for every student to be invested in academics here at U of D. That's why we're here, to be educated. We must all be responsible for our academic workload, our homework, our tests, and our quizzes. But the Senate can also negotiate with teachers and administration how much homework is being assigned and when it's being assigned.
Thank you, Mr. Butler. Gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the candidates for Vice President Sean Butler and Noah Zielinski. Introducing the candidates for Student Senate President, Mr. Kevin Williams and Mr. Jack Ploucher. Mr. Ploucher, as the winner of the primary, you may speak first. You have 1 minute.
Hey, Cubs. My name is Jack Ploucher, and I'm running to be your Student Senate President for the 2017-2018 school year. I'm very qualified for this position because I've been elected to many leadership roles during my time here at the high. I've been dance co-chair, I've been a homeroom rep, very influential in the lacrosse team, and I was handpicked by Mr. Chandler to be part of the new Cub Companion program. I have a great working relationship with the administration, faculty, and staff. I also have a lot of great ideas, with one being an idea that I pioneered myself, the Cub Pride Points Program. This is where grades will earn points based on their attendance at sporting events, theater productions, and volunteer opportunities, and any other Cub events. The grade with the most points will win different prizes like pizza parties and dress down days. Also, I want to have more water bottle refilling stations and many other ideas that will improve the quality of daily life for everyone, not just one specific group. So remember, Cubs, vote Jack Ploucher president on May 12th. Thank you, God bless, and always go Cubs.
Thank you, Mr. Ploucher. Mr. Williams, you have a minute yourself.
Tradition, brotherhood, excellence. These are words we hear all the time that describe our student body. As Cubs, we get up every morning and we work. We fight for each other in everything we do at this school. Now, we need to come together, set the bar higher, go the extra mile. I hope you vote for me to be your president because of my work ethic, creativity, and openness to new ideas. My main goal for next year is simple. Make sure that you're satisfied not only with your Senate, but also with your classmates, your school year, and most importantly, yourselves. I might be late to the dance. This is probably the first time you've seen my face or heard me speak. With that being said, just give me one shot to prove to you that Kevin Williams is the right man to be your Student Senate President. Thank you.
Mr. Ploucher, as you won the primary, we will offer the question for your decision to either accept or to defer to your opponent. As Student Senate President, you are the voice of the student body. What are some concrete steps you plan to take to ensure that you not only represent your friends and your classmates, but you represent all students at U of D Jesuit?
I would like to accept this question, Grayson.
You have 1 minute and 30 seconds.
Well, first off, I like to believe that I have many different friends in many different clubs who enjoy different things because we are such a diverse school. With that being said, I feel like I can successfully represent the student body to the board and to the administration and faculty. This, with me being president, I feel like I will be able to represent the students and be able to get things done. Many people agree that the president doesn't really represent everyone equally, doesn't really know everyone. I feel like I'm easy to talk to, and I'll be able to represent the whole student body, not just one specific group, but every group and every student.
Thank you, Mr. Ploucher. Mr. Williams.
I feel I'm very well involved in school life through many activities, whether it be skiing, soccer, band, or other clubs. But it seems I'm always discovering new things about this school. Just yesterday, I watched the Shell Eco Marathon team test their car out on the track, and I was just amazed at the work they do. I think that I can represent every single Cub, every single club, by staying after 2:45, by making sure that I know every student personally, by making sure that I see and appreciate every single club's achievements. Thank you.
I want to follow up on this one. I want to ask both of you the same question. Both of you said you feel you know the students well, but some students might not feel they know you. So what concrete thing are you going to do to make yourself more open to become the better face of the school? Mr. Plowcher goes to you first, and then Mr. Williams, you have 30 seconds.
Oh, one concrete thing that I feel like I'll do is if any student would like to meet with me and just have a discussion about their daily life at school, how their year's going, some ideas that they have. Like just earlier this week, I met with a student who had some questions about my campaign, and I was more than willing to meet with them and discuss with them what they want to see fit for the school. And so with that, I feel like that's a concrete thing that I'll be able to do for you guys for next year.
Thank you, Mr. Plowcher. Mr. Williams, same question to you. What's the concrete thing you're going to do?
I have two main plans to achieve that goal. First of all, I want to use surveys in homeroom to make sure that every single student has a voice in their Senate. And I also want to work with my media co-chairs to better advertise the events that are happening at this school. That'll make sure that every club is represented and every student feels welcome here.
Thank you, Mr. Williams.
Moving on to the next question. There is a noticeable lack of diversity, at least in terms of race, among the students running for office. Why do you think that is? What can the Senate do to reach out to groups of students who traditionally have not been involved? Mr. Williams, this question goes to you.
Last year, this school's motto was United by Diversity. I can't force any of you to stand up on this stage and become an officer, but what I can do is make sure that I represent each and every single one of you.
Thank you, Mr. Williams. Mr. Plowcher, you have a minute, 30 seconds. Same question.
So the question was, why is everyone running so like one-sided race-wise? And I would like to say that while we have many different people from many different races, we're all here for one goal. And I feel like it's not just up to one person to really represent the whole student body. And so to answer the question, I feel like everyone, no matter what race they are, all can represent the student body well, and it just happened to turn out this way. I don't feel like it was a matter of just being, I feel like it didn't just happen. I mean, I feel like that's just how it went this year, and I don't think there's anything really more to look into it other than that's just who decided to apply for this position.
Mr. Williams, you've requested a response. You have 30 seconds, and again, the question is regarding diversity in terms of race, so if you could please just remain along the lines of that question, that'd be great. Thank you.
I disagree with Jack. While we all are here to graduate, there are many different goals within the school, whether you're here trying to win a state championship or become a smarter person, become a better person, commit yourself to service. You really can't just say that everyone's here for one thing and stick to that. You have to accommodate for every single student and every single student's goals during their time here.
Thank you, Mr. Williams. Mr. Plaucha, your response.
What I meant to say is that we're all here for one goal. We're all here because we're all brothers. We all love this school. And like my one goal, what I meant by the one goal is that we're all here to like have a good time, get a great education, and meet some lifelong friends. So that's just my clarification on what I said previously.
Thank you, Mr. Plaucha.
Gentlemen, the results of the wellness survey, which we took in science class, were recently shared with the students. From these results, what concerns you personally, and what should the role of the Senate be in addressing some of these results? Mr. Plaucha, it goes to you first.
As we all know, the wellness survey asks us about drugs and alcohol, how we're feeling, like if we wanted to hurt ourselves or anything like that. And the only thing that really concerned me was that the national average for the suicide rate is lower, and ours is higher at our school. And that's the only part that really concerns me. And I feel like that is because many people feel like they're really stressed at this school. Many people have many different clubs to go to and then have to come home and do homework, have to study for tests and quizzes. And, you know, people get in a funk, you know. People just don't feel like they're really enjoying their time here. And I feel like that's why that answer to that survey question was the way it was. And so that was the only question that really concerned me, but I feel like there is a good reason why, and I feel like it can be fixed.
Thank you, Mr. Plaucha. Mr. Williams, same question to you.
The statistic that concerned me most about the wellness survey was the amount of people who indicated that they had some sort of mental illness. And I've known many people with mental illnesses, whether it be anxiety or depression. And I think one thing we can do to help alleviate that pain is to be friends with one another, to make this school a more open place, make your Senate more accessible, and make sure that everyone has a voice at this school.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Moving on to the next question. The president attends all of the meetings of the school's board of directors, the people who make the big decisions regarding the school's future. At these meetings, you not only get to share news about what the Senate is doing, but also what you can do to make requests on behalf of the student body. If you were sitting before the board right now, today, what request would you present to them on behalf of your fellow Cubs? Mr. Williams, 1 minute, 30 seconds.
Thank you for that question. If I had to pick one request to make to the school board, it would be, got a lot of requests, I'm sorry. I would request more funding for the media and promotions co-chairs. I feel that they're creativity is left kind of in the dust with the Senate, and what they're able to do, they're able to spread messages around the school, they're able to promote different events, and once we start doing that, there's no stopping us. We can do anything.
Thank you, Mr. Williams. Mr. Plaucha, same question, 1 minute, 30 seconds.
I have two main requests that I would present in front of the board. One would be to have more water bottle refilling stations around the school because there is only one, and as we all know, it's in the new science wing. And so for people who have most of their classes in like the older part of the school and in the new wing, it's pretty inconvenient to have to walk all the way to the science wing to refill your water bottle. So I would like to have more around the school at a more convenient and more convenient spots. Also, I would like to have the ability to wear U of D fleeces inside classrooms, because as we all know, like if you participate in clubs, sports, a lot of times you get fleeces with a Cub logo on them, and you're not really allowed to wear them other than outside of school or on dress down or spirit days. And I feel like if we really want to have more Cub pride around the school, we should be able to wear like fleeces that represent who we are and like what clubs, what sports we're a part of.
Thank you, Mr. Plowcha. Mr. Williams, you have 30 seconds to elaborate further.
Personally, to speak on Jack's point about fleeces, last fall I have been very involved in the Ignatian Service Corps, and I sat in on a meeting with Mr. Chandler regarding fleeces, and he has said that with prospective families and students in our school, fleeces look unprofessional. I would rather focus my time on something more attainable for the student body and something more helpful overall. And speaking on water bottle refilling stations, the Senate cannot rework the plumbing in this school. What about clean water in the cafeteria?
Thank you, Mr. Williams. Mr. Plowcha, you have 30 seconds to respond. Mr. Plowcha, you have 30 seconds.
When I meant fleeces, I meant like any pullover that's like a quarter zip that you can wear. Like many people I know personally on the lacrosse team, we all ordered pullovers that are quarter zips that have the U of D lacrosse logo on them. So to be able to wear that in class would be great. And also, I feel like if they put up the new wing so quickly and put in a water bottle refilling station, I imagine they could put in more around the school in a very convenient time.
Thank you, Mr. Plowcha.
Gentlemen, this will be the last question of our debate. What do you want your legacy to be if you are elected the next president of the Student Senate? Whose turn is it? Mr. Plowcha, it's your turn. Thank you.
If I were elected president of the Student Senate, I want my legacy to be a president who's very easy to talk to, one who leads by example but also has a strong voice in the school, one who, like 5 years from now, people would want to be like, I want the school to be run by a person like Jack Plowcha. I know a lot of people bring up Cole West and how he was such a great president, and people said like he led by example, and so I want to lead by example. I feel like I have the capability to do that. I also want to be leave my legacy that he cared about this school and he really worked for change. He worked day and night for change, because recently in the Senate, I feel like the most they've done is really give us dress down days every once in a while, and that's what a lot of people believe. That's what the Student Senate does. I want my legacy to be that Jack Plowcha did more than just get us dress down days every once in a while. I want my legacy to be that he led by example, led with a good voice, and really changed the school for the better of everyone else.
Thank you, Mr. Plowcha. Mr. Williams, what would you want your legacy to be if you were elected president?
I want to be remembered as the man who worked tireless nights, leaving the school at late hours. I want to be the guy who works for each and every one of you. And I said it in my opening, and I'll say it again. I want to make sure that you are satisfied not only with your Senate, but also with your classmates, your school year, and yourselves. Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. Please join me in congratulating the candidates for president. This concludes today's debate. Let us hear it one more time for all the candidates. On behalf of the Cub News, we want to thank everyone for giving their attention today. We also ask, guys, this takes a lot of courage, and it's really hard to do. If you have any problems with what any of them said, please don't go off on a Twitter rant or anything like that. Talk to them. They're all really approachable guys, and they'd love to talk to you about any of their campaign promises. This way we can ensure a good discussion. But thank you. Please remain seated as we hand the mic over to Mr. Chandler.